TAG TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening, welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Yeshi Chansom. Here are the top stories we're tracking for you on Monday, the 30th of March. Total COVID-19 cases climbed to over 1,070 in India. Taliban must not raise issues with negotiating team, says Afghan official. And Nepal extends lockdown till April 7 to contain spread of COVID-19. And now for all the details. 92 new cases of COVID-19 and 4 deaths have been reported in the last 24 hours, taking total cases to 1,071 and the number of deaths to 29, India's health ministry said on Monday, while reiterating that there has been no community transmission of the virus as of now. India's health ministry on Monday said that the total number of COVID-19 cases rose to 1,071, with 25 deaths reported from 6 different provinces. 92 new cases of COVID-19 and 4 deaths have been reported in the last 24 hours. Addressing a presser in capital New Delhi on current coronavirus situation in the country, Health Ministry Joint Secretary Lav Agarwal said, India, in spite of the population, has limited the cases and urge citizens to adhere to government guidelines to ensure low numbers. The Health Ministry categorically denied that India has entered the third stage of the pandemic and that there has been no instance of community transmission.
We have used the word in a very limited context in a way to highlight what we are going to do action at field. Nowhere we are saying there is community transmission. It is only local transmission in this country. Let me repeat it.
Meanwhile, as the centre has directed provinces to enforce strict implementation of nationwide lockdown to prevent the spread of coronavirus, security has been tightened, with police conducting checks on the movement of vehicles across India. They are allowing only those individuals availing or rendering essential services. Pakistan on Monday reported over 1,600 coronavirus cases as at least 100 new cases were confirmed from across the country. This came amid stepped-up efforts by authorities to fight the deadly infection.
The number of confirmed COVID-19 cases in Pakistan rose to over 1,600 on Monday, with at least 18 deaths, as government efforts to contain the fast-spreading deadly infection continued. This came 2 days after a Pakistan Air Force aircraft carrying relief goods and a medical team from China, which is recovering from the pandemic, landed at Islamabad Airport. Pakistan government has imposed varying restrictions across the country. Public gatherings are banned, schools are closed, and all shops other than those selling groceries or medicines have been shut down. All international flights have also been suspended till April 4. A substantial portion of the infected people in Pakistan are people who have travelled neighbouring Iran, which has been particularly badly affected. Pakistan, as of Monday, reported the highest number of coronavirus cases in South Asia.
Moving on, glaciers are shrinking rapidly in Pakistan-administered Kashmir due to demographic changes and environmental degradation. Locals blame Pakistan, which has over the years exploited natural resources in the illegally occupied region, continues to ignore the alarming situation.
Glaciers are shrinking rapidly in the illegally occupied territory of Pakistan-administered Kashmir and will vanish by the year 2050, an official has said. Deputy Director of Climate Change Center in Muzaffarabad, Sardar Mohammad Rafi Khan, has said the situation poses a serious threat to the availability of water for irrigation, hydropower, horticulture and recreational use. The officials cited demographic changes, environmental degradation, and large-scale deforestation as reasons for climate change. He said the mass of glaciers has shrunk to about 11,000 hectares from 15,300 hectares recorded in year 2000.
اس طرح تقریباً 17 سالوں کے دوران جو ہے 4,000 ہیکٹر جو ہے رقبہ گلیشیئرس کا کم ہوا ہے جو کہ بہت ہی الارمنگ ہے اور اگر ہم اس کی پروجیکشن دیکھیں تو یہ پتہ چلتا ہے کہ اگلے جو 50 سال ہیں ان کے دوران جو ہے وہ گلیشیئرس ہمارے ختم ہو جائیں گے جہاں ایک طرف گلیشیئرس کم ہو رہے ہیں وہاں پہ دوسری سائڈ پہ جو چیز الارمنگ ہے وہ گلیشیئر لیکس کا ڈیولپ ہونا ہے
Locals have long blamed the continuous exploitation of natural resources by Pakistan has gravely impacted the ecology and demography of the illegally occupied territory, and Islamabad has paid no heed. The official said there is an urgent need to adopt climate-friendly policies to overcome the future challenges the region faces.
Moving on. Senior aide to Afghan President Ashraf Ghani, Wahid Omar, has said that the Taliban must not raise issues over the government's new negotiating team for peace talks, as they can also raise issues with theirs. The remarks came a day after Taliban denied to talk to a delegation selected by the Afghan government to move peace talks forward with the militant group.
Senior aide to Afghan President Ashraf Ghani, Wahid Omar, has said that the Taliban must not raise issues over government's new negotiating team for peace talks, as they can also raise issues with theirs. Omar on Sunday said, Afghan government has never said what kind of Taliban should form a delegation, and that is why the militant group should not make an issue out of it. Ghani's senior aide asserted that the government hopes that the Taliban also forms their delegation and the intra-Afghan talks can start. The remarks came as the Taliban on Saturday released a statement saying that the group has some reservations about the peace negotiating team and that the Afghan government can take part in the intra-Afghan talks only as a side like other Afghan factions. The United States, on the other hand, has welcomed Afghan government's team and urged to also form an inclusive government in Afghanistan as the country is into political crisis, where Ghani and his rival Abdullah Abdullah both are claiming the president's post.
Afghanistan's public health minister Firozuddin Firoz confirmed that the positive cases of COVID-19 reached 120 after three people tested positive for the virus on Sunday. As the cases continue to increase, Firoz said his institution does not have access to the required budget to fight the pandemic.
The positive cases of COVID-19 reached 120 in Afghanistan after three people tested positive for the virus on Sunday, said Public Health Minister Firozuddin Firoz. Firoz said that the cases in Afghanistan are increasing and that his institution does not have access to the required budget to fight the pandemic. Meanwhile, a group of volunteers in protective suits over the weekend, supported by a few Afghan private companies, disinfected closed shops, vehicles and streets of Kabul with hopes of stopping the spread of coronavirus.
تمامی اماکن عمر ما دواپاشی میکنیم به طور رضاکارانه بدون کدام هزینه خاص ما از دولت به خصوص وزارت صحت عامه ای است که تمامی نهادهایی که در این راستا کار میکنن اونا را همکاری بکنن امکانات به اینا فراهم بکنن تا ما بتونیم مبارزه خود ادامه بدیم و امی سطح مبارزه خود وسیع بسازیم
Residents appreciated the move of disinfecting the public places. However, there are fears Afghanistan's vulnerable health system, devastated by years of war, would be overwhelmed by an outbreak.
تشکر میکنیم از تیمی که اینمی گروپ دواپاشی را آورده و ویروسی که در اینجا هست را از بین ببره و این بسیار
As part of efforts to control the spread of coronavirus, the government on Friday announced a three-week lockdown in capital Kabul.
In news from Nepal, the Nepal government has extended the nationwide lockdown by a week until April 7 midnight and the ban on international flights until April 15 to prevent the further spread of COVID-19.
Nepal on Sunday evening decided to extend the nationwide lockdown by a week until April 7 midnight and the ban on international flights until April 15 to prevent the further spread of COVID-19. The decision was taken during a cabinet meeting held at Prime Minister's residence in capital Kathmandu. The government had earlier imposed a nationwide lockdown from March 24, which was set to end on March 31st.
अगाडि बढाउनु पर्छ यो लडाई कुनै केन्द्रीय सरकार वा राज्यको तर्फबाट घोषणा गरिएको मात्रै लडाई होइन यो आम जनताले एकताबद्ध भएर मिलेर लड्नुपर्ने लडाई हो यो लडाई यस्तो लडाई हो जो सभ्यताको विरुद्धमा समृद्धिको विरुद्धमा र अहिलेसम्म मानव जातिको जुन उत्थान र विकास भएको छ त्यसको विरुद्धमा देखा परेको यो संक्रमणको विरुद्धको लडाई हो यसमा सम्पूर्ण जनताको एकता जरुरी छ हामी एकताबद्ध भएर अगाडि बढ्नु पर्दछ म यस उद्देश्यका लागि सबै दाजुभाइ दिदीबहिनीहरुलाई विभिन्न संगठनमा आबद्ध रहनु भएका सबै महानुभावहरुलाई सम्पूर्ण राजनीतिक दलका प्रतिनिधि साथीहरुलाई नेताजीहरुलाई हार्दिक अनुरोध गर्न चाहन्छु
Meanwhile police detained people in Kathmandu on Sunday for defying the government lockdown in its sixth day. Officers were seen using a device to keep a social distance from the people they had detained. As per government orders, no one is allowed to leave their houses except for any medical emergency or purchase of essential items. There have been at least 5 coronavirus cases in Nepal and no deaths.
Sri Lankan police has arrested the main suspect who led the suicide bomb attack on Bhattikalausiyan Church on Easter Sunday last year that killed 258 people, including foreign nationals.
The Sri Lankan police on Sunday arrested a key suspect in 21st April 2019's devastating Easter Sunday terror attack that killed over 250 people. Sri Lankan police spokesman Jalya Senaratne said that the suspect had planned the attack and transported the suicide bomber to the Zion Church in Bhattikaloa. He also manipulated the bomber who carried out the attack on Kochikade Church in Colombo on Easter Sunday. The bomber was part of the 9-member suicide group belonging to local Islamist extremist group National Tawhid Jamaat or linked to Islamic State that carried out a series of devastating blasts, tearing through 3 churches and as many luxury hotels on the Easter Sunday, killing 258 people, including 11 Indians. The police had arrested over 200 suspects in connection with the attacks.
Amid coronavirus outbreak and 21-day lockdown in India, citizens are reliving memories with retelecast of 2 famous mythological series of the 80s and the 90s, the Ramayana and the Mahabharata.
Two of India's best-loved epics about gods, demons and devastating wars have returned to the silver screen to the delight of Indians who are forced to sit at homes during a nationwide lockdown to fight coronavirus. People over the past weekend sat in front of their television sets with folded hands, a mark of prayer and respect in Hindu culture as the Ramayana began. Some even broke into dancing and clapping when it showed the birth of their beloved protagonist, Prince Ram.
बहुत अच्छा लगा मैंने अभी तक सिर्फ रामायण के बारे में सुना ही था आज पूरी फैमिली के साथ देख के बहुत अच्छा लगा
The return of the Hindu epics on television is nostalgic for all Indians and has brought back many memories when people used to glue to their TV sets during the telecast in the late 80s.
When we are locked down in the house, it is good that the government and TV authorities have decided to play Ramayana and Mahabharata. So it rekindles our old memories of 80s when we are watching this Ramayana. We are thankful for that.
The Ramayana and Mahabharata are Hinduism's crucial texts. While Ramayana is the story of warrior god Ram, who defeats a demon king to free his wife with the help of an army of monkeys, Mahabharata deals with a dynastic struggle for the power that ends in the victory for the righteous.
Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/sasianewsline. And follow us on Twitter at SAsianNewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow. Good night.